So we're here today talking about people's foster carers fostering moments as part of Foster Care Fortnight. You shared with us your bracelet, and we've got a picture of your bracelet. Can you tell us a little bit more about that and what your fostering moment is?
Yeah, it's a young man that had lived with me for 4 years. He arrived as a 9-year-old, came to live with me, a female single carer, and I wasn't always sure how we'd get on. And it was quite difficult the first year because he actually was told or led to believe that he'd be going home anytime soon, and he didn't. And then the outcome of court proceedings was it would be long term. But after 3 more years, his mum had changed her life and they were able to go home. But during the whole of that time, he would never give me a hug. He had 2 younger brothers who were 4 and 5 when they came, and they gave me lots of kisses and hugs, but he never would until the day that he left. And then he came and put his arms around me, gave a big hug, and then he gave me a bracelet that he'd bought himself, customised it online, ordered it from his pocket money and presented me with it. And I just couldn't believe it. The hug was enough, but that just completely floored me.
Wow. So can you tell us a little bit more about yourself and your fostering journey?
Yep, I started nearly 20 years ago, it'll be 20 years in November when I was first approved. I was approved with my husband and our 3-year-old at the time, but unfortunately that marriage didn't last, so I've done about 15 years on my own as a single carer, looked after mainly sibling groups of different ages, and then a couple of years ago someone else that I met moved in with me and we got married last year, so we're fostering as a couple now.
That's lovely. Thank you. You've seen lots of, over 20 years, seen lots of changes and lots of, you know, different experiences and things like that.
Yeah, I think I've done the whole range. We've done, or I did on my own, mum and babies. I've done little children. I've not done a lot of teenagers. I've had a couple that came as sort of primary school and stayed till they started at high school. But mainly the sibling groups, because it's so difficult to place children together with the siblings. So I've had a few that have been groups of 3 siblings, which means they can stay together until something's decided about what's going to happen to them. I've had a couple that have gone on to adoption. It's just been, you know, a lovely journey, and that's all that we can hope for, that we look after them when they need us, and then in the future they have a lovely happy life wherever they're meant to be.
Yeah, that's